What's up, Keith? New zombie, yeah?
Yeah, the old one I had was falling apart, man, but I got a good one. This one's real good. We're talking less than 2 weeks dead.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah.
I'm amazed they never smell.
Well, the company's got some kind of preservative magic they use. I mean, I don't know how it works, but it works good.
Nice. What's with the girl?
Man, she comes here every morning on the way to school. I don't know. The zombie used to be her brother.
Kind of rude. Can't be good for business.
I know. Tell me about it. Some people just have no respect.
Quit chasing the goddamn pigeons!
So Scott, you ready to start jogging with me, or is your fat ass just gonna keep drinking my protein shakes?
That's not happening. Don't you jog through where that guy was killed last week?
Oh, you mean the werewolf attack?
It's not a werewolf.
Bullshit, it was totally a werewolf.
In Shreveport. If you said New Orleans, maybe.
Believe it or not, Shreveport is blowing up right now, okay? We just got an all-zombie road crew.
And it's completely different than a werewolf roaming the area.
Well, my buddy down at the morgue, he told me that the report said werewolf attack.
Who in the hell do you know that works at the morgue?
Nobody. I'm not a loser. I'm just saying my boy hangs out down there.
And you're going to believe someone that just hangs out at a morgue?
You're right. Maybe it's not a werewolf. Maybe it's a half-breed offspring of a redneck and his stupid hunting dog.
Yo, you got a text message, Crackle.
You know that's got more germs on it than a toilet seat, right?
Not a fact.
Yeah, it's a fact. Mythbusters, bitch.
Well, I would still suggest using the paper rings in public restrooms.
Paper rings? You know, I don't understand to this day how those work.
What do you mean?
Like, is the flap supposed to go in the back, you know, like a shit slip and slide? Or does it go in the front like a nut hugger, you know, to keep your junk from touching the bowl?
I really think it's just there so the toilet will pull it down when you flush.
No, you're wrong. They stick there pretty good.
Stick there with what?
I don't know. Old piss and hooker drippings. I don't examine the shit.
So you mean you don't wipe it off before you put one down?
Then what the hell would the ring be for?
Why do I let you live with me?
Why? I'll give you an answer. Because I'm awesome, we're best friends, and I don't have a job.
Says a lot about me that my best friend couldn't find a job if it were tattooed to his dick, doesn't it?
That's simply not true. Do you have any idea how much time I spend with my dick every day? 23-6. Besides, I got a job interview today.
Really? Like last time we got to spray tan and sit outside of Home Depot all morning?
No, dances with dicks. It's a real job interview.
Well, that's awesome. You should have told me sooner. What time do you gotta go in?
2:00. I'm gonna be running go-karts, working with little kids. Should be cool.
And with your personality, that's not gonna go bad.
Speaking of which, I should probably start getting ready.
Thought you said it was at 2.
Yeah, but I'm gonna snag your computer and go upstairs, visit Pornhub, rub one out.
For 5 hours. You're getting carpal tunnel from that.
It's called stamina. That's why your mom holds season tickets.
Good, go stay at her house tonight. Because I'm bringing home a hottie named Sarah.
What, again? How is your fat ass pulling hot chicks? Wait, did you tell another girl you're a doctor?
Well, it's cheaper than roofies and I don't have to drag them back.
Do they not get mad when they find out you're just a nurse?
Of course they do. How the hell do you think I'd get them to leave?
You gonna give her the rusty dump truck?
The what?
Mona Lisa smile? Helen Smeller? Oregon Trail?
Trail.
Abe Lincoln?
The hell is an Abe Lincoln?
Really? And I'm stupid? Abe Lincoln, he was that president. Got shot in the back of the head.
I didn't say who is Abe Lincoln. I said, what is an Abe Lincoln?
Oh, it's basically the same thing. It's where you're with a girl, and she's like in one of those office rotating chairs. At the last second, you spin her around. Mm-hmm. That way, the back of her head, you just...
Never mind. That is disturbing.
You have a really boring sex life.
Really? Because this one's bedazzled.
What? Got a rhinestone ham wallet?
That's right. And this time tomorrow morning, gonna have a grill blingin' brighter than Little John's.
Nice. That's going to the spank bank.
Speaking of which, the next time you use my t-shirt to make a spank bank deposit, don't put it back on the hanger.
What? Why?
You know what? Just don't even use my t-shirts.
You know what? You're selfish. That's why I'll let you eat my chips. Ridiculous!
This episode of Stiffed brought to you by Magnum Gill. Unseemly odors got you down? Try Magnum Gill Extra Large Flower Scented Condoms. Because when you're feeling not so fresh, the last thing you want is a little squirt up there.
And I walk in and the old bastard's wearing his own shit like war paint.
And you think you got it bad? You start working the extra cares wing.
Can't be that bad, can it?
And the problem with the magically inclined is they get old. They get Alzheimer's or full on dementia.
I mean, they can't work mojo anymore, can they?
Oh, man, you'd be surprised.
I mean, most of them can't get out of bed, and you're telling me they can work hoodoo?
Sometimes they can. Sometimes they do.
Dude, what's wrong?
It's my gooch!
What is that, like an STD or something?
Oh, it's my gooch! It's my taint! My taint!
I don't know what that is!
I got a cramp in my taint!
Dude, you look like you're about to shit!
Oh God, push on it!
I'm not pushing
that, push
bro.
On it!
I'm not pushing that!
For the love of God, push!
Oh God. Dude, do you only have one nut? It's the right address.
Thought you were on a go-kart track.
I do.
So why is this address on your business card?
I like to do things in more of a social setting. You know, really get a feel for the applicant. What?
No, nothing. Just surprised to let you get away with that.
Used to be a bouncer here.
You need to get a bath.
Appreciate it.
Look like two fries. My dick more mass than the earth. Yo dick half staff, it needs work. My dick been there and done that. Yo dick,
the moon make you uncomfortable.
Yeah, we'll go with that. Any other questions for me?
You in a hurry?
No, I'm just curious on how long this interview is gonna take.
We're shutting this place down tonight.
Wow, that's a long time to spend at a strip club.
I like to do things differently. You have a problem with different?
Are you kidding me? I once spent an entire weekend doing shots of tequila out of a hooker's ass in Tijuana.
That's what I'm talking about, man. Drink up. Here's to that Tijuana hooker.
Pablo.
My dick is big. Your dick
is not big. Mine's big.
Hey, Whiskers.
Meow. Meow, meow.
You'll make a fine servant.
Nice. Ow! Oh! Whiskers! Go back up!
Patrick, no one's gonna let us put shock collars on the residents.
I'm just saying, that should work great on my sister's labradoodle.
And there's a big difference between an Alzheimer's patient and your sister's dog.
I don't know, Kevin. I mean, we have trouble keeping them in. And they both piss on the rug.
This episode of Stiff brought to you by InstaBlack Underwear Package Enhancers. Don't let the ladies know what you're packing until you get them home. They have push-up bras and fake eyelashes. Why shouldn't you even the field with InstaBlack?
Dude, are these seats heated? Is that her?
Again with this shit? I told you, man. You owe me $10.
Mm-hmm.
James. Trevor, how nice of y'all to visit me here at the home.
That's your grandsons, Miss Betty, and this isn't the home.
He is screwed, man.
We're screwed. Okay, this is gonna be on us.
We can go to jail for this shit?
Yeah, I'm not. Come on, let's get her out of here.
Come on.
Come on, Miss Betty.
Come on.
Sorry, buddy.
Can we get some dirty movies on the way? Grandpa just loves dirty movies.
Sure, Miss Betty. Why not?
Yeah, I'm sure. Look, I'm a doctor. Hey, maybe you should head on home.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, call me later.
Sorry about your friend.
Thank you. Look, I'm a nurse. Nurse, doctor, what's it matter? I can tell when someone's dead.
So,
you can apply for the All Zombie Road Crew. Does it hurt?
Not really. Like, I can feel it, but it doesn't really hurt.
Hey!
What?
And you're gonna get blood on the couch.
Well, then change this thing. I feel like I'm wearing Courtney Love's miscarriage.
Hang on, I will. Alright, now you gotta be quiet. This is Sarah. And if she's thinking you're dead, I can get some great pity sex. You know what, on second thought, I would reschedule that.
Yeah, what should we schedule?
Hello?
Hey, shithead.
Hide a poop paint spray. Does your city require you to pick up after your dog, but there's no way you're picking that shit up? With a quick squirt, Hide a Poop lets you paint your dog's crap, instantly camouflaging it until you can get away. Available in several colors, including grass, sidewalk, and neighbor's porch.
Well, police are gone. You are now legally dead, sir.
You know, I figured being dead would be a little bit different.
Didn't see yourself getting stabbed to death by a senior citizen in a dementia-fueled voodoo ritual?
Yeah, that. I mean, I figured I would be less mobile.
Well, I didn't figure I'd be housing a zombie in the guest bedroom.
Whoa. Easy with the Z word, all right?
You prefer pulse impaired?
No. It's just, we've seen zombies, and they shuffle around and moan and shit. I don't know, do I look like a zombie?
Considering you have a 2-inch hole through your heart, I mean, that's a little zombie-ish.
I'm going to bed.
You sleep like the dead.
Really? Tits. Oh shit. Oh my god. Oh my god.
What the hell, no shake? What's up? The hell are you looking at? People die and their muscles get stiff. Don't worry, it's temporary. What? Yeah, I'm still not getting that. Oh, how long? A day, two at most. Don't worry, an evening in front of the tube will work wonders for your stress levels.
Hip winger and women who love their men's fathers' fathers. Yeah. Jimmy, what are your thoughts right now?
I just found out my wife's my grandfather.
Y'all understand. Ooh, and he takes his teeth out.
All right, everybody. Oh, you've got to understand. Little kids could see that.
No! No! It's my car, it's my penis, it's my right.
Sorry, dude, but you know that date got rescheduled to tonight? Bejazzled, blingin' grill. You understand. That'd have to do.
This episode of Stiffed brought to you by Knocked Out, spousal strength Rohypnol tablets. Low dosage roofies for when you need extra time to watch football, play video games, or bang the babysitter. Rohypnol, it's not just for date rape anymore.
What? Dude, I thought you were my wingman. You gotta take one for the team. You gotta shut up.
Kill him!
Don't worry, it's pretty much clean. Wow.
Thanks.
Go on in.
You're looking good yourself? You been working out?
Yeah, I've been jogging.
Totally.
So.
Yeah. Did something die?
Yeah, that's my parrot. He's he's sick. It's bad. He's been like a child to me. I don't think he's gonna make it.
You poor, 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 poor thing. First that awful thing with your roommate, and now your parrot.
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, those are shiny. God, dude, last night was crazy. Sorry, I completely forgot about you there. What?
Last night sounded like the ending to Grizzly Man.
So you got some movement back. Nice. I said, well, sorry, dude. What more do you want? Can we set you outside so you can get some sunlight?
I'm not a goddamn plant.
Man, the jazzle beats are not what they're cracked up to be. Where it feels like I'm down a damn cheese grater.
I'm gonna rape you with my truck.
Huh?
I'm gonna rape you with my truck.
You work on that, dude. I gotta get ready for work.
Hey!
Deuces!
Come back!
Honey, I'm home. Oh my god! Dude! You are right. Eric, I see you're moving again. No hard feelings, right? You are not in my room. Naked? Oh my god.
What up, bitch?
What are you doing in my pillow?